لله رب العالمين وصلى وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى اله واصحابه اشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله اما بعد ان اصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الامور محدثاتها وكل محدثه بدعه وكل بدعه ضلاله وكل ضلاله في النار. Just to remind you, I'm Ahmed Rumh, Abu Abdurrahman. Okay. I gave you 4 lectures. I remember 3 topics, but I forgot the 4th one. Can you remember?
Raising kids.
MashaAllah. And?
Very important.
Can I show? Because I know the answers.
Very important about the wives.
The lights of the white.
No, I
wouldn't count. No, they forgot. This one especially, they forgot.
No, I wasn't there.
And the third one was about the boy and the magician.
Yes, I wasn't there.
But I think I just gave you the recap at Anza.
No, this place, they were at my house.
Okay.
Inshallah, tonight I will talk about a very important issue, which is Tawheed, Aqeedah, the belief. Why we have to talk about the Aqeedah, the importance. Or before talking about the importance of Tawheed or Aqeedah, the belief, the meaning of Tawheed. What is the meaning of Tawheed? To believe in one true God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, alone, and direct all aspects of worship and devotion to Him alone. Your salah, your zakah, fasting, charity, prayers, everything, every type of, all the types of ibadah, of your worship, should be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Sincerity, ikhlas. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. And I created not the jinns and men, except they should worship me. So this is the importance of Tawheed. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or what is the wisdom that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us, not only human beings, also jinn, for one reason, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, illa liya'budun, to worship. And some scholars say in the explanation of the word liya'budun, it means liwahidun, for Tawheed, to worship only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةِ الرَّسُولَ أَنْ يَعْبُدُوا اللَّهِ وَجِتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتِ. And really we have sent among every ummah a messenger. Every ummah, it means nation. Messenger. Proclaiming worship Allah and avoid طاغوت. The wisdom that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Nuh to his ummah, to his nation, Ibrahim, Musa, Lut, Yahya, all the prophets and messengers, for one reason, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. أَنْ يَعْبُدُوا اللَّهِ وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتِ. To worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and avoid طاغوت. What is the meaning of طاغوت? Shaitan is طاغوت. Fir'aun is طاغوت. Abu Jahl is طاغوت. Okay? Or the idols are طاغوت. Anyone calls people to worship himself, we consider him as Tawhut. The magician man is a Tawhut. Okay? One day, the Prophet ﷺ was with Mu'adh radiallahu ta'ala anhu, one of the scholars of the Sahaba. Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And subhanAllah, he died. His age was about 35, but he was a scholar. One day he asked, the Prophet ﷺ asked Mu'ad, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, oh Mu'ad, do you know what is the right? مَا حَقُّ اللَّهِ عَلَى الْعِبَادِ. What is the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon his slaves? He said, Allah wa Rasul A'lam, Allah and his Prophet know better. Then the Prophet ﷺ gave him the answer. The right of Allah upon his slaves is to worship him alone. This is very important, alone. And never to associate anything with him. حق الله على العباد أن يعبدوه ولا يشركوا به شيئا. وحق العب this is the right of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And what is the right of the slaves? The right of slaves upon him is not to punish any person who doesn't associate anything with him. This is the result. If you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not punish you. The third ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ بِظُلْمٍ أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ الْأَمْنُ وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. It is those who believe and confuse not their belief with wrong, dhulm, oppression. For them only there is security and they are the guided. Those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is number one. وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِمَانَهُمْ بِظُلْمٍ. It means, يعني, even at the beginning, the Sahaba رضي الله تعالى عنهم, the companions did not understand this verse. Why? Because it is very important when you read the Quran, not only for the non-Arabs, even for us, the Arabs. Yeah, like the second ayah I mentioned, وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ. This word, Ummah, what's the meaning of Ummah? It means here in this ayah, it means a nation, a group of people. But in a different ayah, it means it has a different meaning. Like in Surah Yusuf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَقَالَ الَّذِي نَجَى مِنْهُمَا وَاتَّكَرَ بَعْدَ أُمَّةٍ. You know, when they put Yusuf alayhi salam, the Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam, in the jail, two people came to him and they mentioned the explanation of they asked about the explanation of the dream. So, subhanAllah, one of them killed. And the second one, he said, وَقَالَ الَّذِي نَجَى مِنْهُمَا وَدَّكَرَ بَعْدَ أُمَّةٍ. يعني, he remembered after أُمَّةٍ. So the word أُمَّةٍ here, it means
period of time.
So subhanAllah, the same أُمَّةٍ, ألف or Hamza, ميم, كَا مَرْبُوطَةٍ. The same, but has a different meaning. It depends on what is before and what is after. Another ayah, the kuffar, the disbeliever said, "Inna wajadna aba'ana ala umma." We found our fathers.
Religion.
Huh?
Having a certain belief.
Yes, having this certain belief, and we are following them. So the word umma means religion. So this is very important in the Quran. يعني you need to read the Quran carefully. What is before, what is after the word. So the Sahaba رضي الله تعالى عنهم understood the word ظلم with the general meaning. What is the general meaning of ظلم? If you insult your friend, this is ظلم. This is oppression. If you beat your housemate, this is oppression. If you miss the salah, miss your salah, this is also oppression. So that dhulm is a wide word. But in this ayah, in this verse, the word dhulm means something special. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave the explanation from another ayah. Which ayah? In Surah Luqman. Why? Because the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala, the companions said, Oh Rasulullah, every single man has dhulm. Because we do dhulm. We oppress ourselves sometimes. Maybe we look at something haram or we say something haram. You cannot escape all the dhulm. The Prophet said, no. The ayah here, not like what you understood. It means like the wise man. What the wise man said to his son, وَإِذْ قَالَ لُقْمَانُ لِبْنِهُ وَيَعِذُهُ يَا بُنَيَّ لَا تُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَظُمٌ عَظِيمٌ. Who is the wise man? Luqman. His name is Luqman. What he said to his son? Don't do shirk. Why? Because Shirk is the biggest dhulm, or is a biggest, is a big dhulm. So this ayah, we took the explanation from the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam from another ayah. If you believe in Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, and you don't mix your belief, your tawheed, with any type of shirk, then أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ الْأَمْ وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. أَمْ, the secure and the day of judgment. Why? Because people in a very difficult situation, the day of judgment. Even the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, يحشر الناس يوم القيامة حفاة عراة غرلا غير مختونين. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, in the day of judgment, people, Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala will gather people in one place, naked, without slippers, without shoes. Then Aisha radiallahu ta'ala said, O Rasulullah, men and women see each other. The Prophet said, at that day the situation is very difficult. They will not think like dunya. So subhanAllah, that day it is very difficult. It is very difficult. But for the believers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them this security. If your heart is pure with tawheed, there is no shirk, and there is no any type of worshipping other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your heart. أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ الْأَمْ. So what is the أَمْ? What is the secure in the day of judgment? أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ الْأَمْ وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. You are guided in this dunya. We need the guidance. Why? Because in every salah, it is in every salah, or in every rak'ah, not only in every salah. In every rak'ah we say, اهدينا الصراط المستقيم. What's the meaning of اهدينا الصراط المستقيم? Yes, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the guidance. And we ask, alhamdulillah, we are Muslims, but we want to die with Islam. This is very important. The most important thing is the end. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have a good end. What's mean وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ? What's mean the guy you are guided in this dunya? It means if there is any problem, you say alhamdulillah. If you lost your son, if you lost your money, your car, your job, you will not shout, you will not curse the day. You say alhamdulillah, you say inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un, Allahumma ajurni fi musabati wa akhluf li khayra minha. This is the meaning of guidance. So this is the importance of tawheed, that if your heart is pure, you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, it means you'll be guided in this dunya. And the akhirah, you'll have the secure. Look, this hadith is very nice about the importance of tawheed. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, indeed Allah has forbidden for him the person who testifies none has the right to be worshipped but Allah, seeking there be nothing but Allah's face. Why you pray? You want the Jannah, you want the paradise. Why you are feeding the poor people? You want the paradise. Why you are making da'wah? Why you are inviting people to Islam? You want? As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Insan, إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمْكُمْ لِوَجِهِ اللَّهِ لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا. We feed you, waiting the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمْكُمْ لِوَجِهِ اللَّهِ لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا. We don't want anything from you. We don't want the newspaper to put our names, because this is subhanAllah, this is problem now. Not all of them, some of the teenagers, they do something, a project or something, just they want to show people. They want to speak on TV or the radio. And this is a big problem, subhanAllah. No, it is not important for me that people know that who's giving who's feeding the poor people, or who's doing the good thing for others. You write fa'al khair. You know, when you go to the lajna, okay, when you want to give the charity to the lijal, they ask, what is your name? Or you want us to write fa'al khair?
Donor.
Okay, they ask you your name, but or they give you the option. Do you like to write your name or we write fa'al khair, donor? Yeah, alhamdulillah, many people write fa'al khair. Yeah, no need to write the name. Yeah. So subhanAllah, this is a great hadith. That, yani, if you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, khalas, the fire is haram to touch you. Another great hadith about the tawheed.
In this hadith, Allah Sayyidina Muhammad said, shall I tell the people, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? I think he said...
Hadith Mu'ad?
No, is that the same hadith?
Yes. About the hadith, the first hadith, the Mu'ad radiallahu ta'ala said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, shall I tell people? This is, mashallah, bushra, glad tidings, yani, to inform people. That if you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, khalas, you'll be in Jannah. Okay? The Prophet said, no, please, don't tell people. Because if you tell people this information, they will sit at home and khalas. They will not work. Maybe you'll say, okay, why the Prophet said this to Mu'ad? Because the Prophet knows that Mu'ad will not change his action. Will not Umar, Uthman, Ali, all the 10 Sahaba, they know they will be in Jannah. They are sure. Did they stop Qiyam al-Layl? No, they did not stop. They did not stop charity, alhamdulillah. So, and this is very important. If you know that people will continue praying Qiyam al-Layl, Tahajjud, okay, you tell them this hadith. But if you know your children or your friends that after knowing this hadith, they will stop, better not to tell them. Also another hadith, the same meaning, the Prophet ﷺ gave his shoes to Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And he said to Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, take my shoes or my slippers and see the first man you meet. Give him my slippers. Why? Why the Prophet ﷺ, yani, wants to give him the slippers? Because it is like a stamp. It is like a stamp that it is the Prophet, from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And tell him you will be in Jannah. Who faced Abu Huraira?
Abu Bakr.
Umar, he faced Umar radiallahu anhu. What Umar did? Directly, he beat Abu Huraira. He beat Abu Huraira. Then he, Abu Huraira, went back to the Prophet ﷺ and told him, Oh Rasulullah, you told me to give your slippers to the first man I meet, and I tell him that you are in Jannah. And I faced Umar radiallahu anhu, and I did what you told me. But he became angry and he beat me. Then Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, the Prophet said, he said to Umar, why you beat Abu Huraira? I said, يعني حتى لا يتكل الناس, يعني, don't tell people that you are in Jannah, because then people will depend on this information and they will leave the ijtihad, qiyam al-layl, and the worship. Okay? Another great hadith to tell you the importance of Tawheed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in this hadith, يَبْنَ آدَمْ لَوْ أَتَيْتَنِي بِقُرَابِ الْأَرْضِ خَطَايَ ثُمَّ لَقِيتَنِي لَا تُشْرِكْ بِي شَيْئًا لَأَتَيْتُكَ بِقُرَابِهَا مَغْفِرًا. Allah said in hadith, they call this hadith Qudsi. Hadith Qudsi, it means from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. O son of Adam, were you to come to me with the world full of sins and meet me without making anything partner to me, yeah, without shirk. What is the meaning of meet me? It means you die. Your death, you end your life with tawheed, without shirk. Without making anything partner to me, I would come to you with a similar amount of forgiveness. You will not find this much of reward except in tawheed. If you avoid shirk, you will find this this much of reward. Subhanallah. The last hadith about the importance of tawheed, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one hadith, saw a group, in a dream. So our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw the prophets. This hadith of Bukhari, saw prophets in this dream. He saw a prophet with few followers. Rahat. Rahat means between 3 and 10. Also he saw another prophet with two men. Only two followers. Third prophet with one follower. Also he saw a prophet without followers. Subhanallah. Imagine a prophet making da'wah, maybe for 10, 20, Allah alam, how many years, without followers. Subhanallah. Then our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw like a black cloud. Then he said, oh Allah, this is my ummah, this is my followers. Alhamdulillah, I have too much followers. Then it was said to him, no, these are the followers of Musa alayhi salam. Then our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw the other side, he saw also a big, he saw a black cloud. Then it was said to him, this is your ummah. And among them, 70,000. These 70,000 people will enter Jannah directly, without checking. Subhanallah, yeah, it is like now first class they have a special door, okay, but this is Jannah. It's Jannah, it is different. Without checking. Nobody will ask them. يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةَ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ وَلَا عَذَابٍ. They will enter Jannah without any type of punishment. And nobody will ask them. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was telling this dream to his companions. Then he stood up and left this gathering. Subhanallah, the Sahaba, the companions discussed who are these people, the 70,000, who will enter Jannah without any counting, without punishment. So some of the Sahaba said, okay, this group which became who born in Islam. Yeah, and they mean the old Sahaba were kuffar. Then they became Muslim, like Umar radiallahu anhu, he was kafir. Khalid Walid was kafir. Then they become, so they have something before Islam. So they said, okay, maybe these 70,000 people who born in Islam. Then subhanAllah, they mentioned more than one opinion. Then the Prophet came and he said, what you are saying? They said, we are discussing who are the 70,000. He said, this group, the 70,000 people, هم الذين, the Prophet did not mention a tribe or names. He mentioned criteria to give us the chance that we join them, inshallah. هم الذين لا يسترقون ولا يكتوون ولا يتطيرون وعلى ربهم يتوكلون. He mentioned 3 points. هم الذين لا يسترقون, يعني they don't ask others to make ruqya. You know ruqya, to recite ayat, verses, or some hadith, some dua for as a treatment. They recite the Quran for themselves, but they don't ask. Okay, this is one meaning of the la yastaqun. Number two, ولا يكتوون. They don't use the cotton. They don't use the fire for treatment. It is not haram. It is not haram, but it is recommended to avoid this. The third one, ولا يتطيرون. They are not طيارة التشعب هو بس بس.
Optimist.
Optimist.
Optimistic, متفائل.
متفائل.
Pessimist. Opposite of optimistic.
Pessimist.
You're not pessimistic.
إيه ما في كلمة ثانية التشاؤم؟
لا فيها اللي هي اللي يتشاؤمون ولا لا
ولا تطير التشاؤم؟
طيارة.
من الطيارة اللي
الطيارة.
الطيارة
التشاؤم يعني.
Giving
a bad luck, giving a bad luck,
superstition. Yes, الطيارة. Yes. الطيارة. What do you mean, الطيارة? They, in Arabs, they used to use the birds, pigeons, or any type of bird. Yeah, for example, this man wants to travel. Before traveling, he will take the spirit of pigeon. Then he will release the spirit. If the bird went to the right, he said, "Khalas, I will travel." If the spirit turned to the left, no. This traveling is a bad traveling. I will not travel. Or if it is a marriage, or if it is a trade, I will not do. Because of a bird. Of course, subhanAllah, now, it is not only with the birds. Now with colors, numbers, number 13. Okay, so maybe the black color or maybe
666.
That meaning
13.
13. 13. 13.
13.
666 is like evil,
evil.
And the sign of the beast.
Yeah,
sign of the devil.
Not in America, in the West.
Yeah. In the West.
But it's not number 13.
No, number 13 Jews.
Yeah, 13.
Friday the 13th.
Friday
the 13th floor.
So those who have what the
black cat,
they're on top of
black cat, yeah.
Black cat.
SubhanAllah, this is haram. And this is shirk because the Prophet said, الطيرة شرك. It is shirk. This superstition is shirk. And be careful, even sometimes our children. Or not our children, with us, or some of us. How? If you like hunting, you like to hunt the birds, maybe you say, if this person will come with us, I will not go. Why? Because every time he comes, we don't hunt anything.
SubhanAllah.
So this is shirk. Or if this man plays with us the football match, we will lose. So I will not play with you.
We sometimes do it, tell it for fun. But it's dangerous.
No, in shirk, there is no fun in shirk.
Yeah.
Yes, be careful.
Yes.
Be careful. Okay? Or maybe I will not wear these shoes. Why? Because every time I put on these shoes, we lose the match, the football match. Okay, be careful with our children. Okay, they don't like, for example, this T-shirt. Why? Because every time I play, I go to the school with this T-shirt, something bad happens to me. This is shirk. Okay, the scholar said, why it is shirk? Because you believe that this T-shirt or this beard or this number can do something. Can change the things of no everything from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The rain comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All you hunt in the, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent this place to you. Not because of this person. Okay, maybe you say, no, this person doesn't know how to play. Okay, this is a different story. But his existence, some people believe his existence is a problem. No, this is haram. This is haram. Okay? So if you have these criteria, لا يتطيرون ولا يتطور ولا يسترقون, you don't ask people to do ruqya, to recite Quran on you, and you don't use the coterie, and you don't have the superstition, if you notice the three of them,
tawakkul.
Yes, equal tawakkul. The fourth sentence, وَعَلَى رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. They have tawakkul, they depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you have these four criteria or three criteria, then inshallah you will be one of the 70,000. Of course, now we'll say 70,000. Of course, finish.
You've been singing that the whole time.
because the number of the Sahaba, the number of the Sahaba who did Hajj with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, more than 100,000.
Yeah.
So of course we don't have any chance. No, alhamdulillah. Say alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, with every 1,000, 1,000.
For everyone or every 1,000?
Every 1,000. So it is about 4,900,000 people. صح؟70,000
70,000 into 70,000. The number 70,000.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said
1,400,000.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said 70,000. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, with every 1,000,
there will be 1,000. 70,000.
Yes, with every 1,000, there is 70,000.
SubhanAllah. So there are 70, actually there are 70,000, but for every 1,000,
70,000
will follow. So it's like,
that's the
total. It will be 4,900,000.
So that's the total inhabitants of Jannah, or that's just for that
category?
No. This group will enter Jannah without any shifting, anything.
Okay, but the actual number of people in Jannah will be more.
Oh, infinity.
Okay.
Jannah is not limited.
Yes, the people that fit this criteria.
Ah, fit the criteria.
Yes. Also another narration, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, وَثَلَاثْ حَثَيَاتْ مِنْ حَثَيَاتْ رَبِّ.
الله أكبر.
And يعني also three hands from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How much? Allah أعلم. يعني Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will add three hands from him, people. How much? Allah أعلم. Millions. Allah أعلم. But the point is, if you notice, it tells you the tawheed, the ikhlas sincerity. Depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't see others. Don't ask others. This is the importance of tawheed. Because unfortunately many people don't care about tawheed.
In practice.
Yeah, why? Because alhamdulillah, we are Muslims. Why you want to talk about tawheed? Or why you talk about shirk? Okay? Inshallah, I will mention some points quickly. Or enough. Maybe inshallah, in another halqa, quickly I will go through some of the types of shirk. Like this, what we are talking about, superstition. Okay, in every house, people suffer from superstition. Some of them know and some of them don't know. So inshallah, I will tell you about some of these points. Okay, to tell you the importance of tawheed. JazakAllah.
Any questions, brothers?